rounding off decimals. Now, when are we supposed to round off the decimals? Sometimes what happens is, when you are dividing or when you are simplifying any values, what happens is you get your answer in decimal form. That is the time you can actually round it off. Like for example, you have 98 rupees in your pocket. And if somebody asks you how much amount of money do you have, you tell it approximately, yes. What do you tell the person? You tell that you have approximately 100 rupees with you. So that means you are rounding off the values. So that is how we are going to learn in the similar way, rounding off of decimals now. How to round off the decimals? The first step is, the first digit of decimal part is either 5 or more than 5. Now you have to see the decimal part in the decimal. You have an integral part and you have a decimal part. So as we know, we have an integral and decimal part both. We are only going to consider the decimal part for both the cases, right? That is done. The next part is, if first digit of the decimal part is less than 5, here it was saying if the first digit is 5 or more than 5, you have to check the first digit of the decimal part. Is it 5 or more than 5 or lesser than 5? The first digit has to be 5 or lesser than 5 or greater than 5. So we have to check the first digit in the decimal part, which is 5 in this case. So if the first digit of the decimal part is 5, what should be done? Increase the integral or the whole number by 1. Now this is the integral part. We have to increase this by 1. So what would happen? You would get your answer as 24 plus 1. That gives you 25. This is the approximated value. Why? Because here in the decimal part, we had the first digit of the decimal part as 5. So we increase the integral part by 1. What about the second case? Here we have the first digit as 4. Now the first digit of the decimal part is lesser than the 5. Yes. So what should be done now? For this case, what is to be done? We have to remove the decimal part and keep the whole part only. Just forget about all of this decimal part and your answer would be 19. That's it. Now I have discussed both the cases. So first of all, for rounding off, you have to consider the decimal part only. In the decimal part, check out the first digit. If the first digit is 5 or more than 5, for example, it could have been 16.812. Then it would have been rounded off. You would have checked, this is the decimal part. The first digit is 8, more than 5. That means the integral part needs to be added with 1. So that will become rounded off to 17. If it would have been 16.34, here the decimal part is having first digit as 3, which is lesser than 5. So this will be written as 16 only. Right? So these were the cases when you have to round off the decimals. Now we are going to do the rounding off of decimal number to required number of places. Now sometimes what can happen is, the question might ask you, give the answer in approximate two values. Sometimes your decimal, your division is coming out like this, 2.1246 and so on. And the question is asking you the answer in up to two decimal place. How are you going to do that? So this is the case that I have drawn, right? The examples I have taken up. So let us do it. The first step is, consider the digits in decimal part. For here also, we have to consider the digits of the decimal part, that is these digits, right? Now the decimal part is to be considered. If the digit is 5 or more than 5, remove the extra digits and increase the previous digit by 1. Here, which digit are we talking about? The last digit. Here also we are talking about the last digit. I have purposely not written here so that I can tell you clearly the difference between here, this one and this one. Here we have to consider the last digit. The last digit of the decimal part. If the last digit of the decimal part is 5 or more than 5, we remove that extra digit and increase the previous digit by 1. So what happens here is, here we have the decimal written as 28.464. The 464 is the decimal part. The last digit of the decimal part is 4, which is not this. The last digit is lesser than 5, then just remove that extra digit and keep the remaining digit. So what we do is, we will remove the digit and keep the remaining digit, which will be as 28.46. This is the rounding off up to 2 decimal place. What about this one? Here we have to round up in 3 decimal place. That means we have to get rid of third one. But please check, in the decimal part, your last digit is greater than 5 now. What is to be done? We remove the extra digit and add 1 to the previous digit. We remove 8 and we add 1 to 6. So what would it become? 54.32, and you add 1 to 6, it becomes 7. So you can see, I have removed 8, I have added 1 to 6. So by that, we have got the round off depending on the required number of places. This can be done for any number of decimals depending whatever the question has asked.